All right, the major component of the anterior thorax is your rib cage. And you have to understand that on each side you have 12. 12 ribs equal 24 in all, and they're very different depending on which area, from superior to inferior. Now, I want to focus on what we refer to as a typical rib. That's usually ribs about 3 to 10. This one is rib 8. And I want to talk about the structures that you'll find on almost all. So I have this organized how it would actually be located in the body. You're going to have your sternal rib end right here. That's going to be anteriorly placed because you're going to have costal cartilage that will extend to the sternum. And then the more complicated portion of the rib is going to be more posteriorly placed because that's what is actually articulating with your vertebral column. So you have the head of the rib as well as the tubercle of the rib. The head of the rib is going to articulate with the body of the vertebrae, whereas the tubercle is going to articulate with the transverse process of the vertebrae. Now remember back in our discussion of the vertebral column, which vertebrae are actually articulating with ribs? Out of the cervical, thoracic, and lumbar. It's thoracic. You have 12 thoracic vertebrae, 12 ribs. One other thing I want to note in a typical rib, you have this divot right here on the inferior portion of the rib. This is kind of a cradle for the intercostal neurovasculature. So you have an intercostal nerve, artery, and vein that are going to travel in this area. So you have muscles here, but also the divot really helps to protect that important neurovasculature. Now, there are some atypical ribs that I want you to note. I did not bring a 12th rib. It looks basically like a finger. There's very little curvature to it. You don't actually have much cartilage associated with it because it's not actually extending up to the sternum. So we refer to that as rudimentary cartilage. But the first two ribs I want to talk about first. So here is a first rib, and you can see how curved this is in comparison to a typical rib, and short. And this is a second rib, so a little bit longer, but also fairly short in comparison to the typical rib. Now, the first rib, as its name would indicate, is going to be the most superior of the ribs. It's very well protected, so it's going to be underneath this clavicle region and closely associated with a lot of important neurovasculature. So your subclavian artery and vein, as well as your brachial plexus, very closely associated. Two muscles are going to attach here. You're going to have your anterior scalene as well as your middle scalene. So if you can see how robust this area is right here, it's because you have muscles actually attaching there. Now your second rib, as we were talking about, it's a little bit longer but still very curved. You're going to have your posterior scalene attach here. So your complex of scalene muscles are attaching to your first and second rib. Now let's talk a little bit about the costal cartilages associated with ribs. We discussed this when we were talking about the sternum. This is what's actually attaching to the sternum. Ribs 1 through 7 are going to have their own or their individual costal cartilage, so they have an individual attachment to the sternum. Whereas ribs 8 through 10 are going to attach to the costal cartilage above it, so kind of forming the shared costal cartilage that heads up towards the xiphoid process of the sternum. And that's really what's going to form that costal margin that you can palpate right here. Ribs 11 and 12, those are going to be referred to as floating ribs, and that's because their costal cartilage, which is rudimentary, isn't going to extend all the way to the sternum. So very important in terms of giving your thorax a bit of flexibility, which is important in terms of breathing and inspiration.